Honorable members, the Speaker's efforts to contain the escalation of differences were clearly unsuccessful, and the time has therefore now come to make difficult decisions.
From the onset, the Speaker appeared edgy, probably because for the first time he was going to take on the head of state head-on in his ruling, a ruling that would vindicate the Prime Minister and go directly against the President's wishes.
It is unconstitutional, and the unconstitutionality cannot be cured by any act of this House or of its committees, nor by a vote on a motion in the House.
Members supporting the President were waiting with bated breath for the names to be tabled in the House, knowing they had the numbers to push through the names of the nominees.
I rule order. Order, honorable members, order.
Had the Speaker's ruling taken that direction, they were certainly headed for a win, but the Prime Minister and his allies appear to have had the last laugh.
The effect of this ruling is that this House shall not proceed with any process of approval in respect of the nominations that the National Assembly received from His Excellency the President.
That is not acceptable.
Members supporting the President in a hurriedly convened press briefing condemned the ruling immediately after the House adjourned. However, members who were happy with the decision said it was a measure of the checks and balances in the Constitution aimed at preventing the executive from arm-twisting the other arms of government.
The Speaker's ruling is not just right when it supports us. It is right because it's constitutional, and it is right because it abides by the Constitution.
The Speaker's ruling was anxiously awaited for across the nation to provide the way forward on a stalemate that had held hostage the Constitution implementation process and left the House poisoned in acrimony.
Honourable members, the House shall await nominations for the respective offices to be forwarded in the manner provided for by the Constitution.
The two principals may now have to go back to the negotiating table to come up with a fresh list of nominees to the positions of Chief Justice, Attorney General, Director of Public Prosecutions and Controller of Budget before presenting it to the House for approval. Sylvia Tibet, Citizen Live at 9.